We play and call it work.
Hey everybody, Matthew Josh here from MiniWarGaming.com, and welcome to the semi-final match of the MiniWarGaming Blood Bowl League! You've already seen Steve and Lee face off. Should I give spoilers?
They've already seen it, so spoiler alert, I guess.
Spoiler alert! You know, skip the next minute. Steve was the victor, and Lee got knocked out in two games. And the third game, that third video was just for your viewing pleasure, of course, seeing Steve dance. We put a third video in there so people wouldn't know. Same thing's happening today. You're gonna see there's gonna be three videos posted. If you want spoilers, of course, jump to the third video and see if it's if we're playing or not. But if you don't want spoilers, then just watch them in order and just see what happens. But so, anyways, yes, this is a best 2 out of 3 matchup, which means we'll play either 2 or 3 games. The first one here is free, and the other 1 and/or 2 will be in the vault. The Mini Wargaming Vault at the links in the video description below, and we can't have ties. Mm-hmm. So we play, and we have changed the rules of the sudden death, meaning that we don't play another 4 turns. If we go into overtime, the first person to score a touchdown wins. It's just we felt that was good for our filming purposes, and I just think it's more exciting, to be honest. I know some Blood Bowl players are like, no, there's a reason why they do it, and I totally get it, but we're just doing a short league, and let's face it, it'll just be a lot of fun that way. So no ties allowed. So we're playing to win, not just to make sure you don't lose. That's a big difference in those two mentalities. So it's going to be my Chaos team against Josh's Lizardmen. And so let's see, E-Reptile Dysfunctionaries? Eastern Reptilian?
Eastern Reptilian Dysfunctionaries.
Yes, so hopefully you figured it out by now. Against my Corn Crushers. And last time we played in the round robin, we tied.
Yeah, it was a tie.
And it was actually a pretty close game. Obviously, it was a tie. It was a close game, but I even mean like beating each other up.
Yep.
And so I have no idea what to expect. We've both upgraded since then. We've both gotten better at the game. And hopefully we won't get as many rules wrong as we did before. And that's just what we'll have to do. So this is game number 1. Let's jump right in. On this side, we have the Corn Crushers. This is my 11-man team, or 11... thing, team. I don't know if we can really call them all men. We got Beast Men and we got Chaos Warriors who once were men. And my team value is 20,000 less than Josh's team value, but I'm not really going to use that for anything because 20,000 is not enough. I'm going to save my treasury for game number 2 and really go all out, unless I'm winning, in which case I'll probably save it for the finals. But we'll just have to wait and see. So we've got a few upgrades. Number 1, Flame Snout has been upgraded to have Frenzy, so that allows him to block twice if he doesn't knock down the person when he blocks him the first time. Then we have number 4, whose name is Roger. He's got Dodge, so he's Roger the Dodger. And number 8, Chaos Warrior, actually gave him +1 agility. So he's a tough guy who actually can pick up the ball and throw it, theoretically. And then number 11 has block. So Chaos Warrior with block is kind of scary, but let's face it, dice could really do whatever the heck they want. And that is my Corn Crusher team.
Over here for the Lizardmen, going through the upgrades. Player number 2, the Saurus there, has block, but also -1 armor value permanently.
So he's minus, so he's armor 8 now?
Armor 8 now. And then moving down the line, Skink number 8 has got leap. Skink number 9.
What does leap do?
It's basically an agility test, and I'm able to jump over you.
Without any negative. Line. What if you have negative modifiers? Like if there's people in your, like if you're right here and I'm right there.
I get to jump 2 squares.
But do you have to get a negative modifier for everybody in your?
I don't believe so. I could double.
We'll double check that, but not right now. We'll double check that after.
I just wanted to say that I'm a leaping lizard.
A leaping lizard.
Skink number 9 has sidestep.
And sidestep lets you choose where you go when you're blocked.
When it's pushed, yeah.
Just pushed? What if you're knocked down? Do you get to choose where you go there too?
No, I think it's just on the push. Number 10 has just -1 move.
Okay, that's his upgrade.
And then the Croxagore, upgraded to have piling on. Not the best upgrade, but kind of a hilarious one, so I went with it.
What does piling on do?
It allows me to re-roll. If I fail to break your armor, I can knock myself over, and I get to re-roll it, knocking myself down. It's in the square that I'm currently in, and I also do not... It's not a turnover.
Okay, and you don't take an injury check or anything? Nope. Or armor check?
Yeah, I'm cushioned by your body as I...
So basically you're like... You're dogpiling on the guy just to try to hurt him again.
Hulk Hogan atomic leg drop on you.
With his tail, though.
Correct.
With his tail.
Now, also, the other one is I can do that same thing for the injury roll if I don't like the injury roll. It's one or the other.
Okay. So he can do more damage, but at the cost of dropping himself onto the ground.
Right.
Got it. The weather is nice. It is sunny and shiny, which means there will be no negative modifiers. And we just have to roll to see how many of our fans showed up. Now, I have a fan factor of 4, and...
I've got 3.
You got 3, so I have a better chance. We roll 2d6 plus our fan factor. Ah. Ah. So you got a higher one. So you get plus 2 fame, or is it plus 1? I guess...
Double the roll. Plus 1
fame. So you got plus 1 fame, because you didn't double what I got. Flip the coin.
Okay, you're going to call it?
Yeah. Heads. Tails. Do you want to be receiving or kicking?
I'll receive the ball first.
Okay. And we are set up and ready to go. Of course, me being the kicking team, had to set up first. Nervous about putting 5 guys in the line of scrimmage, but just didn't want to leave my Chaos Warriors there all by themselves. Although they could fend for themselves, but, you know, just, yeah. Just how I feel about the whole thing. And then you've got your skinks in the back, and obviously everybody else lined up, mostly on the one side and not on the other. So we'll see how that goes for you. So I'm going to kick off. Let's try it right here. Scatter 2 to the 7. Don't like that, but I'll take it. Kickoff fence. 6 cheering fans. We each roll D3 plus fame. Oh, the winner gets a reroll. So I get D3. Ah, you're going to win that automatically. Ah, you're going to reroll already. I'm not liking where this is going. Scatter it one more time to the 8. And closer to my lines. Dysfunctionary turn 1.
You go number 2. Throwing a block into your, was it number 5?
Number 5. Okay, 2 dice. These are straight 4 versus 3. You got him.
So we'll knock him back that way.
Are you going to... follow up. Apparently saying follow through makes UK people laugh.
Yeah. It means something different over there.
Tee hee hee.
Nope, not gonna follow up.
Armor 8. Oh, right away? What is going on? Okay, let's see the injury table. Thankfully just stunned. That's how you play. You just automatically get knockdowns and injure people. That's how you play.
Number 1 gonna throw a 2-dice block into the Chaos Warrior there.
Oh, just a push.
Push you to there, and I will follow up. Number 3 is gonna go into number 4 there.
Oh, just a push.
I will push you to...
There's only one, so it's actually only one option. Are you gonna follow up or no?
Nope. Number 4 into the Chaos Warrior there.
You got him. I do not have block. Or sorry, dodge. I don't have dodge. Dodge would have stopped that.
Knock him down there. Follow up.
Armor 9.
And 10.
Oh, good.
And go boop.
Boop.
Boop. Boop. And we're going to go for a blitz.
Against?
To here, into him.
Number 2.
Yes.
And you've got the advantage. 2 dice. Just a push. I'll take it.
I'll push you to here and follow up.
Croxagore?
Croxagore into that Chaos Warrior.
Let's see if he's dumb, though.
Oh, yeah.
Roll a 1. Uh-huh. He just goes, nope, he can go. Strength 5, so 2 dice. You got him. Somewhere to go, so you get to push somebody else as well.
Yeah, let me just see where everybody actually is.
Push and knock one down back.
Stunned guy. And then knock you down to there.
You gonna follow up?
Yes, sir.
So armor 9, but you do have Mighty Blow, so you could add 1 to this if you roll a 9. No? Now, do you want to drop yourself onto the ground with Pylon?
Don't need to yet.
No, not yet? Okay.
Number 9 will go... does he get the bonus? No, he doesn't have the bonus. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 to try to pick it up.
3 up to pick it up. Got it. Still can move one more before you have to go for it if you want to. Gonna go back?
Actually, 8.
Can you go for it?
I will try to go for... No, I can cage up around him. 7 will go... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 8 will go 1, 2, 3, 4. Number 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Corn Crushers, turn 1. First things first, stand up our 2 fallen Chaos Warriors. Neither of them are going to blitz, so don't have to worry about their actions. Number 8 is actually going to advance 1, 2. Number 3 will advance 1, 2. Number 6 and 7 are going to advance like... So you can move 8, right?
Correct.
All right, well, let's get to here. Number 1 is going to frenzy and throw a block into number 6. Sorry, not frenzy. He's going to blitz. He's got frenzy.
Yes.
So if he doesn't knock you down, then he has to follow up. Well, he has to follow up no matter what, and they can go against. I'm going to try to push you off. I am strength 4 because of horns and blitzing, and then I have help, so strength 5 because this one is currently engaged, so I do have advantage. And I'm going to choose the push, obviously, and I have to follow up, and then I will throw a second block, obviously still strength 5. And we got a push. Out you go. Injury check. So he is in reserves. Number 2 will go next. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Sorry, if it looked like I went to that square, I thought I went there.
Yeah.
So where was he? He was right here, because he had to follow up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, I could have gone one more. Okay.
No, because he was back here, right?
Oh, that's him. Yeah. I'm thinking of him, yeah. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, that's exactly where he needs to be. Got it. I'm good. Number 10 is going to go throw a block into your Croxagor. He's going to have help, so we'll be dice even, which makes me nervous, but, you know. Ventured. Got him! I'm going to knock him down back here. I'm not going to follow up. Armor on your Croxagor. It's 9. Oh, look at that! Now, he does have a thick skull,
yes.
Which means he a stunned is on a 2-8 rather than 2-7. Permanent or injury. D68. I want to see a 6 on the D6.
Don't you dare. Don't you dare.
35. He's just out for a game. Sorry, not even out for a game. He's just out for this game. Bad. Getting him knocked out for even
fella.
Just one game would be awesome. But you know what? This is turn 1, so he's essentially knocked out for an entire game. Number 4 is going to dodge away. He does have the dodge skill, so 3+. Rerollable. Okay, good. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And that, as they say, is that. So my stun player is no longer stunned. And that's it for my turn.
Dysfunctionaries, turn 2.
Starting off, we're gonna have number 2 go 1, 2.
Just engage everybody.
Number 1 will throw the block into number 3.
At advantage, strength 4 versus 3. You got him.
I'll knock you back to there.
Follow up.
Kind of don't want... No.
No. Armor 8. Fine.
I do number 4 into number 8.
Help. So he's strength 5. Knocks him down.
I'll knock you to here. And follow up.
Armor 9. Fine.
5 will blitz.
Oh, I left him open for being knocked off. 2 dice. Ah, you got him. Pushed him off. Unless you want the both fall down one.
No. Do
you want the both fall down one?
No.
You gonna follow up?
No, I won't follow up.
So, injury check as he crowd surfs. No, just reserve. I guess he deserved that as it goes into my reserves pile.
I can go...
You used one of your movement to...
Yep.
To
block. So that was... Because he was here, right? So
yeah, 1, 2, 3.
Yeah, 6 to there. Move over to the skinks. We're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And I try to keep that formation going. 1, 2, 3, 4. four, five, six, seven. Go up for eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight.
This one's at minus one movement.
Correct. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Last block, I can throw number three into
nine. Even. Push. You're going to take a reroll?
I'll take a reroll.
Okay, you don't want to push. You really want to knock him down, eh?
Yeah, I've got a bunch of rerolls. I'm used to having two rerolls.
Skull. Rolls are supposed to backfire. That's what they do to me. I'm like, just need a 2+ rerollable. No and no. Arm 9.
Show me a 10.
Hey, injury table.
Maybe another high dice roll. I'm sort of mad.
Better be now. Nope, stunned. I'll take it. Corn Crusher's turn 2. Number 8 is going to stand up. Number 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Number 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And number 3 will stand up. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm going to throw a blitz. Number 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Throw a block into 4. I'll be strength 4 with horns and with advantage. Gotcha. So I'm going to knock it down, and I'm not going to follow up. Armor 9. No, you're fine. Number 11 is going to throw a 1 die block and a 3. Number 11 has the block skill, so this is safer for me. Unless I roll a skull. Okay, got him. So I'm going to knock 3 back to here. I'm not going to follow up. Armor 9. It's fine. Number 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, go for it! 2+! Go for it! 2+! Alright, we're good. Number 2 will throw a block into 5 with 2 assists, bringing him to strength 5. Push. I don't like this, but I'm using a reroll. Screw me over. Okay, it didn't. You don't have dodge on number 5, right?
Nope.
I'm gonna knock him down here and I'm not following up. Armor 9? Nope. And then 10 will throw a block into number 1? Because you got block in number 2, right?
I do.
I don't like that then. Because I could do number 2 with help, but then you'd have help. So it'd be dice even no matter which way. And so, just do it. No reroll though. Oh, that's off the thing, so it doesn't count. Unfortunately, I would have gone for a push. Okay, got him. Oh. Back, beast, back! And I will not follow up. Armor 9? Dang it. At the end of my turn, 9 is no longer stunned.
Dysfunctionaries, turn 3.
Have him stand up here. He'll stand up, and then... Boop, boop. He'll stand up here. He's going to declare blitz. So 3, 4, 5, and then into number 2.
So you have advantage, strength 4 versus 3, push.
Push you to there, and follow up. 2 is going to throw a block into number 10.
You'll get an assist, and I'll get an assist too, so dice even. Got the block skill. Ah, didn't matter.
So I will send you back that way, follow up.
Armor 9.
Over here now, so we're gonna go. Ooh, where do I want to send that cage? I can kind of go this way, or gonna go around. 7 will go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
What are you worried about the gauntlet or something? Are you worried about like putting your guys up here and having this whole gauntlet?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm
yeah?
terrified of it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
10 is down.
10 is the slower one.
So yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Number 8 will go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Corn Crusher's turn 3. Number 10 will stand up. Number 9. Oh, wait, let me think about number 9 for a second. 3 is going to go back. 1, 2, 3, 4. Number 4 is going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Bring it, guys. Just bring it. I dare you. 9 is going to go 1, 2, 3, 4. 5 will retreat. 2, 3, 4. Five. I'm okay there. Six. There. Number eight is going to blitz. One, two, three, four to throw a block, and I'm strength five against your two, so I actually get three dice. So that should be like a sure thing, right? Yeah, okay, good. So I will knock you down back this way, and I will follow up. Armor seven. Aha! Now, since you have stunty, I essentially get a plus one, because you treat a seven as an eight and a nine as a 10, and that's really the only one that matter. Seven is an eight, he's knocked out. See you later. Number 11 is gonna throw a two die block into number two. We both have the block skill, but I knock you down. So I don't have any empty squares to go to, so I'm gonna push number two into 10, and then the only square that 10 can go into is here. So just trying to slow you down as much as I can. I will follow up, yes. Armor nine.
Armor eight.
On your Saurus?
Yeah, because it's the one that...
Oh, he's the one that's minus one?
Yep.
Okay, so you're normally nine, but he's correct. Eight. Number two is going to dodge away. Three plus. Good. And then he'll go, oh, now that he got away, maybe I want to go for your skinks. First, I was going to wrap around so I could just beat this knot out of five, but what's five going to do except just knock down number six? So I know you get to dodge away, but I'm going to make it dodge. So let's go. That was one, two, three, four, four, five, six. Now I'm gonna make them both dodge. There we go. And I won't activate these two because they have a lot of dodging to do, and any blocks they throw will be bad blocks, or as they like to say, bad blocks.
Dysfunctionaries, turn four.
Two will stand up. Start with number five and a number six.
Good luck. Got him. Only one place for him to go.
Yep.
Are you going to follow up?
I will.
Armor eight. He's fine. Number three into number seven. Still only two dice. You strength six versus three. You got him though. Only one place to go. Are you going to follow up?
I will.
Armor eight. Ooh, we got him. Injury.
Roll big.
That is knocked out. So it'll come back on a four plus.
Yep, that was the right one. Number four is gonna blitz, so we're gonna go one, two, three, four.
You've got help. So two dice. You push. You're gonna take one of your rerolls.
Yep.
Down to two rerolls. And again.
Come on.
I've got the block skill.
So it's push.
So you use it as a push instead, yeah. So it has to go there. You gonna follow up?
Yes, indeed. Number seven will go. One, two, three.
Okay, I'm like, what are you doing? Where are you going?
Number eight will throw the block.
The guy with the ball is throwing the block?
Yeah.
All right, how could that go wrong, right? You do have help, so you have the advantage. Skull, skull, skull.
Come on.
Skull, skull, skull. Oh, it's not a skull, but it was so good. Fine.
Meh, meh,
meh. Meh. Are you going to follow up?
No.
No? Okay. Armor eight. Yes, he's fine.
Number, was that number 10?
Yeah, the stunty one.
Cool.
Or the one that's one less movement.
Go back here and foul you.
So you're declaring a foul action before you moved?
Oh, sorry, yeah, I gotta call it first, but.
So thanks, Matt. No, you're not allowed to do it because you moved before you called it. I'm not gonna be that guy. For the finals against Steve, I'll be that guy. So you get plus one because you got help.
So I gotta show an eight.
Yeah, you gotta get an eight or higher. Not a double though, so at least you didn't get thrown out.
You know, number one and number 10.
One die block. Push. I'll take that.
Push back.
Although you getting knocked down would have been nice too. Corn Crushers, turn four. Number two is going to stand up. Number six is going to stand up. I know that means that he can just get punched again in the face, but I don't want number three, number five to easily walk away because your agility sucks in your Saurus, right?
Yeah, it's agility one.
Yeah, so you walk away and you've got to roll a five plus.
So, yeah.
Yeah. Eight will move. One, two, three, four, five. 10 is going to advance. I am... I want four to blitz to get into the guy with the ball. But it's two dice with the reroll. Yeah, I got to use his reroll now. So he's blitzing. One, two, three, four, five, six. Go for it.
Don't waste one, 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 one.
Don't waste the reroll on the go for it. Oh. Thank you. Two dice block. You do have dodge, though, which that dodges.
Yep.
So I will use my reroll. I'll be down to one reroll. That's just a push. That's better than nothing. 11 will throw an assisted block against number 4, and I do have the block skill. I'll knock you down. I'm going to send you this way to kind of block up this alley, and he will follow through. 9. Good. Number 9 will advance. 1, 2. Number 3 will advance. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then 5 will advance. 1, 2. Actually, I'm going to have him go back to here. And back one more. Dysfunctionaries, turn 5.
Lizardman here will stand up.
Number 5 is going to throw a block to number 6.
Got him.
So we'll go ahead and to there. Follow up.
Armor 8.
Big roll, big roll.
No.
Now we're going to go 2 dice into number 8.
From 3. You got him. We have not filled a block yet. Have you noticed that?
I don't think we have.
I think we've both done one reroll, but we have neither of us have been knocked down by our own blocks. So armor 9. That is very unusual. Oh no! Injury?
Roll big, roll big!
Roll! What are you waiting for? Okay, just stunned. Good, because he's the one with +1 agility.
Number 2's gonna throw a block to number 4 there.
Try to free up those skinks.
That's the idea.
And you gotta push. Want to use one of your rerolls? Ooh. Part of me wants you to do it so that you get double skull. The other part doesn't want me to do it because then you just get a push. Just a push?
Just a push.
You gonna follow up?
No, I'm pretty comfy where I'm at. Can I go for the one dice block number 8 into number 2?
He's helped by number 10. it's just a push. I'm happy with a push, but I would have really liked this. Both knocked down, even. I would have taken that.
Yeah.
Following up?
Nope. Number 10 is going to move over. Number 7 will blitz.
Throw a block into 4. He has the advantage because he got 2 helpers. Oh, just a push.
Push you there.
You gonna follow up? Still costs you 1 movement no matter what.
Yep. And then we'll go. No, I'm not going to follow up.
So that's 1. Okay.
Let's try for number 2 into number 9.
Single die roll, but you got block. Push.
We'll push you back here and not follow up. Go for number 1 into number 10.
These guys. There we go. You want to use your reroll? That's the first bad roll we've had.
It's going to be, because you don't got block on him, right?
Nope, so we're both knocked down. And it'll be a turnover, but it's your last guy.
I could live with that, I think. So
hopefully it injures you and not me. We're both armor 9, though. Throw against my armor 9. Dang it. I better injure you, too. Just done. 7 or less. No! Knocked out. I'm not going to hurt you, am I? Armor 9. Oh! No!
No, it's 9.
No, it's 9. It's 9. It's so close. Core crushing turn 5! Stand up, Beastman number 6. Number 4 is gonna blitz! He's gonna blitz! And don't know where. I'm gonna go here. I'm gonna blitz number 8. Or block number 8. I just wanna know if I should go here and push him. Or go there and push him. I can get into the same. No, you know what? I'm gonna go there. Bam! Meh! Strength 4. Got help.
Double skulls.
I don't want just a push. I'm using my last reroll.
Oh,
it's a big risk.
Reroll.
Yeah! I got him. That was risky because you have the dodge skill too.
Yep.
So the ball ends up where you were or where you go to?
I think it bounces from where it was.
No, it goes from where you go to. So I'm going to follow up. And we're going to check your injury. Then we'll scatter the ball. And then I'll continue my blitz. Armor 7. Yes.
Oh no.
Yes. We basically have +1 of this. Out you go. That is injured. 2 points for number 4. Injury. He's dead. Was that Sarah?
That was Sarah.
I don't feel bad. Then we scatter the ball. I'm hoping I don't roll a 5. Oh, seriously. So it scatters on a number 7, but you have to try to pick it up when you have somebody stopping you. So you got a 5+ to pick it up. Okay, good. So we scatter it again. 2. Oh, well, hello. Also a 5+. Oh, I got the ball! I got the ball!
Dang.
And he hasn't even activated yet. Well, la-di-da, eh? How about them apples? Don't have any more rerolls, though.
Yep.
I'm gonna take a big risk. I'm gonna dodge. It's a 3+ reroll. Well, it doesn't sound risky, but I know how dice work. Yes! Oh. I apologize for the obnoxious noises, but they were necessary. 3, 4, 5, 6. I've got to support that those two last guys over there. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I know this could mean I get a bruising on your turn, but I got to do it.
Mm-hmm.
11 is going to throw a block into 4 with an assist. I got him. I'm going to knock him down into this square. And... I don't want to follow up because I need to keep these guys. Although I have 9. I got 9. He can come back. Yeah, I'm going to follow up. Number 9. Oh!
Oh!
Oh, this is not looking good. Oh, knocked out. If I knew that was going to happen, I wouldn't have followed up. But that's why you have to choose before. Dodge! 3+.
1 or 2. 1 or 2.
Hey! 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I am not going for it. Number 9 is going to go... Have we blitzed yet?
Yeah,
he blitzed. That's right. Yeah, that was kind of the big one. Yeah, duh. He's going to go there. And that, as I say, is that. Dysfunctionaries, turn 6. You still have 2 rerolls. Only 1 can be used per turn, of course.
Yep.
But the fact that you have a reroll this turn is...
kind of nice.
I don't like that.
Flew a little bit too close to the sun. Going to be cheeky. So number 3 to number 3.
Double skull! Oh, you got him. Yeah, number 3 is not the one to dodge. You going to follow up?
Yep.
Armor 8. Ah, you got him. So maybe this will work, that you just get to beat the snot of my team and win in the second half. Yeah, he's out for the game. 2 experience for your number 3. Permanent injury for my number 3. Nothing. He's just out for the rest of this game.
Number 5 and a number 6.
It's a coach just yelling, just kill the ball!
Murder them now!
Just murder the ball when they're going to get a touchdown. Make sure there's nobody for the second half. Armor 8.
Should we 9?
No.
Number 2 and a number
5. Just a push. Want to use one of your 2 rerolls?
Don't need it yet, no.
No? Oh. Dang it. Meh. I really hoped you would.
Number 1 will blitz. So 3, 4, 5, and then 6.
The skinks help, your strength 5. Just a push.
I'm gonna use the reroll because I'd be lucky if I can knock him out.
Just a push. It's like the dice all of a sudden went in my favor. They were pretty even throughout the whole game. We were both making our rolls. And then now
they're like,
and then it's like, nope. Yeah, Josh just run down the clock. Don't like that. Gonna have an interesting game, Josh. Not just run down the clock.
It's been interesting.
It is interesting. I think it's great.
Number 10.
You can only go 7.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And then I go for it.
Where are you gonna go for the go for it?
Right there.
2+, no rerolls. Got it.
7 will go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, that's good there.
Don't want
to
risk that.
I didn't think about that. I moved into your square.
Well, you were going to move around.
Boom, boom.
There was a way for you to do it. Corn Crunchers, turn 6. No reroll. I need a 3+ non-rerollable dodge. I think I got to go for that first. And now the most nerve-wracking roll of the entire game. A 3+ dodge with no reroll. And if I get it, I get a touchdown. What the frickin' crap dice? It is messing with me. Okay, armor 8. Don't you dare hurt him. Don't you dare hurt him.
Oh.
Thank you. Okay, now it's not over yet because it could possibly scatter off. Okay, it is scattering off because it could get thrown back on and land on his heads. And if I catch it, then I could get a touchdown. So that's my last chance. So it's going to get thrown back on. Starts right here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I'm looking for a 1, 2. Okay. But then it goes 2d6. I need 4. Exactly. 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then it scatters once. That's so mean. Why are the dice jerks? I wanted to say other words. And I was dumb. I didn't stand on my guys. This is like a 3 plus. I was so fixed on that. Turn 7 for the dysfunctionaries.
7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
3 plus. You do have a reroll. You need to use your reroll. Didn't even have to use a reroll.
8.
Number 2's going to throw a block into number 5.
You've got the block skill on him. Nope, just a push. Don't want to use your reroll?
Nope.
Not important.
So we're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5,
6.
Yeah.
So you're not going to do that?
Scratch it. I think I got a better idea.
A better idea? You're not going to go for a touchdown then?
Well, no, I am, just in a different way. He's going to stay there for now, depending on what happens. 3 is going to go for a blitz.
A blitz? Throw it against 11?
Yep.
11's got block. Does that make you nervous?
A little bit.
Push. Good enough, right? Or do you really want to use that reroll?
I'm just trying to think of where they're going to end up. Then you back that way.
Follow through. That's 1. Do you want to keep moving?
10 will go 1, 2, 3.
Do number 1 against number 5.
Against number 9.
What is that?
1 die block. No special rules. You got him. Lucky duck.
So I will go boop. Follow up.
Armor 9.
Time to roll a 10.
Oh. Now with how the turn went out, I'm going to go with the original plan. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
So basically, if I don't get the ball from you, you're going to move up, go for it, hand off, and then touchdown. Oh, Corn Crusher's turn 7. Well, 9's not blitzing, so he's going to stand up. So number 6 is going... Oh, no, he can't be the blitzer. He'll have to go for it. Go for it. Don't like that. Well, if that's the case, then he's going to go 1, 2, 3. Well, he could go 4, 5, 6. Go for it. Go for it. But I have no rerolls, so I don't want to leave you wide open for that chance. So they go 1, 2, 3, and I can just make it harder for you to get to your guy. So let's just do that. 4, 5. I'm happy, right? No, let's make it a 6. Make it even harder. 11 will blitz. He's going to dodge away. 3 plus. Well, that was worth trying. No rerolls. Blah! Onto his face. Hopefully not. Armor 9. Good. At least he didn't get stunned or anything. That's a turnover.
Number 3 is going to go for a blitz.
Illegal procedure.
Oh, yeah, you get your reroll.
Yay! I don't know if I need it at this point, because I don't think I can get a touchdown.
Everybody gets one.
Everybody gets one.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And boom.
2 dice. You got 1 reroll left. Got him. Yeah, I don't have dodge on him. You gonna follow up or not?
Nope. Don't want to get my...
Armor 8. He's fine. Now is time for the touchdown 1, play.
2, 3... 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
And you're doing a handoff, right?
Yep.
I'm assuming. You didn't say it, but...
Yeah, we talked about it off camera for a while. It's a handoff.
He never declared it.
You were going to jump on that one.
I knew it was. So yeah. A 2 plus go for it. This is your first one that you have to do. Okay, go for it is good. Now you got a handoff, which happens automatically. He's got an agility of 1, so he's got a 5 plus to pick this up because it's an accurate pass. And you do have 1
reroll. Catching the handoff's just the plus 1.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, essentially it's like an accurate pass. 5 plus. With the last reroll, and if he doesn't get this, no touchdown for you.
Come on!
No! No touchdown for either of us. Actually, that is not entirely accurate, because we got to see where it scatters to. Yeah, no. Goes right there, and that is a turnover. So, my turn 8. I gotta go for the ultimate Hail Mary. I actually have a very, very, very slim chance of a touchdown, which means I'll probably make it.
Yep.
And thank you for the reroll. Just want to point that out in advance. So what we're gonna do first, though, because I hate your skinks, is I'm gonna throw a block into that one.
Skull is...
Nope, got him. I don't care about following up. It is funny that my whole Hail Mary thing actually involved him being the catcher, and I realized as soon as I knocked you down, I'm like, oh. But I recalculated it. It'd be moving up, 5+ dodge, 5+ dodge, then a 5+ to pick it up, then a 5+ dodge, and then probably like a 6 to throw it. And then if I make that, then he'll have a 4+ to pick it up, and then a 3+ dodge.
Yeah.
you could do the math. And I don't think I can make that many dice rolls. I can't make a single 3+. But even put that aside, forget like bad luck and stuff. That's just very unlikely. So knock your skink down. Armor 7. Okay. Plus 1. Dang it. Just stunned. So nothing really. Yeah. Number 6 will blitz. Ha! Still have a reroll.
You're welcome.
yeah. Oh. I'll just push you there and whatever. Number 11 will stand up and then move. And then, well, he's turned sideways. He hasn't gone yet, right?
I don't think he has, no.
Yeah, 9 will throw a block into 1. No more rerolls. I knock him down unless he has dodge.
No.
Number 9?
Number 9.
No. Probably going to regret this. Going for a foul. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Fouling. Armor 7. Hey, I didn't get kicked out of the game. And you're stunty, so plus 1. Hey, I injured him. So he's at least out of this game. And he's just out of this game. And that is the end of the first half. Holy crap. You had the ball for a while. Then I got it from you. Almost got a touchdown. Failed a 3+. Then you got it back from me. But then I almost took it from you. But then I failed a 3+ dodge. I'm sensing a pattern here. And fell on my face, which allowed you to go for it. A 5+ rerollable is all you needed. And you failed it. Which, really, I didn't have much chance of a Hail Mary. So I was able to injure one of your players. So at least we have that. You've got 2 injured players out for this. And one dead. So that's you're down 3 guys. Possibly 2 more. I'm down 1 guy. Possibly 2 more. But at the very least, it's going to give me a big advantage as we go into the second half.
Don't forget to check out the other games in the Mini Wargaming Vault, because I'll be upgrading.
End of the second half, we've got to see who comes back in. The reserves automatically comes in. Knocked out, number 10, 4+. Any other guy? Oh, no, you better not. I need a big lead. 4. No! Did you skink? Yes, okay. Whew. Second half, we're all set up, ready to go. Josh is the kicking team, I am the receiving team. I got my number 8 with higher agility. I know he doesn't look like much of a receiver, but he is. Just don't be deceived by looks, okay? All you prejudiced people out there, okay? Stop it. Just stop it. And then Josh decided that he wanted to threaten me with all of his Saurus warriors, as if I'm threatened by those little guys, although none of them are actually out. So basically, your army is now a bunch of Agility 1 guys team. With your team with a skink. But and now you are going to touch down super easy. You watch. You'll make your 5 up. No source problem.
Catch and just walk the board.
6+ catch, walk up the board. Nobody will take it from them. And so I've got my blocker here, and then just a regular cast warrior, and then just some beastmen to help out. I've got my frenzier, and Roger the Dodger is up on the one side. Kick off! Scatter, made a 6. Oh, it's back. 1, 2, 3, 4. Kick off event. 9 is a quick snap. All receiving team players are allowed to move 1 square, ignoring tackle zones. I'm gonna move Goatman back 1. I'm gonna move 8 back 1. And I'll move up number 4. And we'll move up number 1 as well. And then 1 more scatter. Oh, nice. Yup. And now it is my turn. Horn Crushers, turn 1. Don't like the idea of trying to pick up the ball, so I'm going to do some other stuff first. 11's going to throw... Oh, no, number 2's your blocker, isn't he?
Yep.
We've both got block. Okay, I've got the advantage. I don't just want to have the advantage. I want to beat you. I'm going to throw it. Here we are, 2 dice. Got him. Down! Down! I will follow up. 9.
8.
Oh, because he's down 1?
Yep.
Didn't matter. And he's stunned. Take it. Would have been nice to knock him out, but I'll take a stunned. 9 will throw a block into 5 with an assist from 11. I'll push. And there's only one place to go. Not going to follow up. And then when number five will blitz, I will move him one, two, throw a block. And I'll be strength five with the assist. And with horns, I'll push. Seems all I can do to number five is push. And I will... I'm not going to follow up. It leaves him open, but I have other plans. And now the most risky part of the game, trying to pick up the ball. Three plus. See? Got a reroll. Good. Jeez. Don't like that I had to use the reroll already. Oh, I was doing a handoff. We talked about that.
Yeah.
You knew I was doing a handoff. I didn't announce it, but I gave a couple of them to you last time. But you're being nice, so I don't have to say
it. We talked about it off camera.
Yeah, we did. So that was one, two, that's two, three, four, handoff. Number eight is agility four, so he actually has two plus. Good. Yeah, I was so expecting a one now that I've lost my reroll. Eight's going to advance. I'm not going to initiate a pass. He's really good at passing. He'd be a two up to throw a quick pass, but I don't trust my guys to catch on a three plus. I'll wait till there's a turn when I can have a reroll again. So he's just going to move five. No go for it's. Number four will advance. One, two, three, four, five, six. Frenzy number one is just going to advance. We're going to go one, two. I want to make it hard for you to get to number eight. And two's just going to sit tight. He could throw a dice even block against six, but if I knocked two down and not six, if I knocked both of those down, I know it's a two plus chance that I get something that's okay, because six doesn't have anything special, right?
No.
I'm throwing the block. Okay. I'll take it. I will push him away from the touchdown line, obviously, but the real question is whether I will follow up. And the answer is obviously no. That was the obvious answer, obviously. Dysfunctionaries, turn one.
Number four is going to start off. We're going to go one, two, three, four, five, six. Number one is going to go one, two. Scratch that. He's going to go up this way instead. So boop, boop. Number seven will go... one, two, three, four, five, six, to there. Number five will blitz. Let's see if you remember where he was going. It was one, two, three, four, five, and then boom.
Two dice, strength five versus three. Four has dodge, so that's a push. Is he gonna be satisfied with the push?
Yep.
Well, not satisfied, but not going to go for a reroll?
Correct. Number three, bring it back. One, two, three, four, five, six. Number six and then number nine.
With help, push.
Push you up, follow up.
End of your turn, he is not stunned. Corn Crushers, turn two. Number 11 is going to advance. One, two, three, four. My frenzy number one will blitz. One, two, three, four, five. Blitz into three, or block into three. Strength five because of horns and help. I don't have block, so I'm doing a push. So push. I have to follow through. I've got frenzy, and then I throw a second block, and I have to throw this one, so this dice even. Dang it. I am going to use my reroll. I know it's dangerous, but this will be a turnover, not where I want to be. Okay, well, at least we're both knocked down. Don't like that. Should have moved up my ball first, but yeah. Armor nine against you. No, and I've got armor eight. Okay, good.
Okay, so for my turn, there could be a blitz somewhere. I think we're just gonna have him.
Illegal procedure.
Oh!
Yeah, get a reroll back. So he moves three spaces so far.
Four, five. Two will blitz, so three, four.
Throw a block. You got advantage and block skill. Push.
I'll just go for that push. We'll go boop. Number five into number four.
Yeah, try to knock me off the field. I don't like that one. Ah, you got him. I've got dodge, so that turned into a push. That's all you needed. Do you want to follow up?
Nope.
Injury table? Just reserves.
Seven. Ugh, do I want to bring you up to try to help?
Just a little skink.
But then you're going
to... kill all your skinks?
So, he's going to go one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight.
Now, number four to number six.
Knocked him down.
And I'll follow up.
Armor eight. Good.
Six into two now.
Got him.
Back to there and follow up.
Armor eight. No.
And then for two dice, number one into number nine.
Oh, just a push.
I'll take the reroll. Might be a bad decision, but
you never know with the reroll, right?
A little bit more.
Double skull. You got him. Phooey. And armor nine. No, you didn't hurt him at least. Corn crushers, turn three. Right away, I've got to stand up. I just can't leave you guys free in case any of this really sucks and doesn't work. Master plan, blitzing number one. He's my friend's ear. He's going to stand up and throw a block into three with help, so I'll be strength five because I got horns. That is a push I will choose. I am tempted to take the both knocked down, but I can actually do a second block. I actually have to do a second block because I'm a friend's ear. Still with help. And I got him, unless three has got dodge.
Nope.
So I will knock him down back this way. I have to follow up. Armor nine. Oh, he wasn't the one that was hurt, right?
Nope, it was number two with four.
Ah, that's too bad. And then I will advance one more. Yeah, because he did five already. Three to stand up, two blocks.
Yep.
So one more. I don't like this part, but it should be easy to do. Number eight is going to declare a handoff. One, two, three, two plus dodge, because I've got agility four. Okay, thank you. Didn't want to reuse the reroll on that. I wanted to use the reroll on handing it off to my guy with block. Handoff is automatically successful, so it's a three plus. Good. I'm so confused. My pass worked without rerolls. What am I supposed to do now? I guess complete the rest of my plan? And then the guy that got the ball is going to go one, two, three, four, five. Let me think for a second if I want to go for it. And I'm going to leave him where he is. And I'm not going to activate number 10 or number five. He's just going to stay threatening your blocker. And that is all of my guys. So not a bad turn. The ball is getting pretty darn close to your touchdown line or your end zone.
Dysfunction areas, turn three.
Three will stand up for three. Four, five. Five's gonna go for the blitz. I think we're gonna go one, two, three, four, five. And then throw straight ahead.
Push him back. Two dice because you're at strength five, but I've got block. Just a push. I'll take it. Just make it harder for me to do anything. Now see if you can do some damage. Four into six. Both knocked down or pushed. Your choice.
I'll push you back. That way.
And then your blocker into number five. Two dice with block. Ah, so you got him. Follow up or no?
Yes.
Armor eight. No.
Number
six into number two. Knock down. Well, one thing I have to say about this game is the blocks have not disappointed. Well, not disappointed the blocker. It's always disappointed the blockee. Because if the worst we're doing is a push, he did not hurt him, then this, the dice have been kind. Number one, with help for number six, and then number nine. Also knocked down. So basically, I gotta get a touchdown, or my team's just gonna be lying on the ground. Number nine. Good.
Seven's gonna move up so slightly and foul that beast man.
With help. Means you only have to roll eight or higher instead of nine or higher. Nope, but no doubles, so you didn't get kicked out of the game. Corn crushers, turn four! I've got a plan, but before that plan starts, stand everybody up in case the plan doesn't work. This is a three-part plan. You ready for this?
Yep.
Number eight, advance. One, two, three, four, five. Number one, my friend's ear, blitz. One, two, three. I got to throw a block into him. The idea is I just need a push because then I need a three plus dodge and away we go. I don't want to have to use a reroll for this. That's why I'm trying to get the advantage as much as possible. But if I have to, I will. Got the push. The only scary thing about that push is I have to follow up and do it again, but now I don't have the advantage. I'm only strength 4. And if I get knocked down, okay, we're good. So I'm going to push him back there, and I have to follow through. So there we go. Or follow up. Sorry, English players. And then once again, it all comes down to a 3+ dodge. This time I've got a reroll.
One or two.
Ah! Ah! Ah!
No! Oh. And it runs in for the touchdown!
Touchdown! Touchdown! Yeah!
This episode brought to you by Ikelia. Extra parts always included. Guys, I'm knocked out, guys. See if your skink comes back in a 4+. Oh, no. Come on, Chaos Warrior.
No! Beastmen?
Okay, good. I'd rather have them the Chaos Warrior, but I just need to keep my advantage in number of guys. We are all set up and ready to go. I am kicking, obviously, because I got the touchdown. Let's put 3 guys at the line of scrimmage, and a couple in each wide zone, and then a couple back, we got my Frenzier, my Higher Agilityer, my Blocker, and my Dodger. And then you've got your 2 skinks at the back, and obviously all the Saurus Warriors out front, ready to punch their way through the lines. Obvious place to try to drop the ball is on this side. And it scatters 1 of the 6. Oh, scatters 1 more, that way you could pick it up. Kickoff event. 4, it's perfect defense. The kicking team's coach may reorganize his players in a legal defensive formation. Well, a couple of the obvious things are to move these guys up. I'm gonna close up this line and bring number 2 back to here. Scatter it 1 more. If on a 6, you could actually pick it up. 7. Still not horrible ball placement. Right in front of your guy, right in the middle.
Before anything else, I'm going to move up my turn.
I started to record because he told me what he was going to do. But he didn't touch the guy. So, and didn't throw any dice, so I can't call legal procedure. So turn 4 for the dysfunctionaries. So then we know it's 4 into 7, yep, already. So with advantage, knocks him down. 7's not anything special.
We'll knock him back, just straight back.
Follow up. Armor 8. Not a bad start. Hopefully you're just stunning him. Yes. Stunned.
9 is going to go for the ball. Ooh, do I want to try handoff? He's going to try to pick the ball, but he's going to go for the handoff. So.
3 nope. Plus. 3 rolls left. You got it. Where's he going?
Go. Boop. Boop. Boop, boop.
3 plus to pick it up. Drops it. You gonna use a reroll? Or are you gonna just leave it in the way in the back?
No,
of your
I gotta
lines?
Go for the reroll.
Gotta go for the reroll? Yeah. Yep. You don't want to turn over yet. 3 plus. Well,
oh,
Lottie.
No.
Scattered. If you roll a 1, you might end up. Nope, you didn't. So it just ends up 10. There. No, 3. It's back.
But it goes off of him, doesn't it?
Yep. But it's back in the diagonal. See? 3 is back in the diagonal.
Ah,
there we are. And that is a turnover. Corn Crusher's turn 5. There's a couple of obvious things I need to do. Number 6, 1, 2, 3, oh, hold on. 1, where was he? He was right here, right?
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm not gonna go for it. I just don't wanna waste my 1 reroll.
Okay.
8's gonna go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Number 5 will advance. Number 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Number 9 is going to throw a block against number 3 with assistance, so I will have advantage because he's tying up everybody else. Got him. Going to knock him down. I'm not going to follow up. Armor 9. Nope. Number 4 is going to declare a blitz. 1, 2, need to dodge. Plus, and he's got the dodge skill. Ooh-ah. Good. 3, 4. Five, and then a blitz. I actually get 3 dice for this because I have horns and help, strength 5 versus 2. And you have dodge.
I do.
So that's a push. Well, I'll just take the push. We're 2.
I think that might be my sidestepper.
Is that number 9?
Yeah, is number 9 your sidestepper?
Yep.
So you choose which one to go into. So you got this one or this one.
He's already went, right?
Yeah. Yep. There. And then I will follow up, obviously. Number one just needs to come over to help. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. See, yeah, I don't need to go for it. Number 11 with block will throw a one die block into number 4. Got him. Knock him down. I will actually follow up. Armor 9. Ooh, we got him. So we're at least stunning him. Stunned. So he's stunned. That's my last guy, so 7 is no longer stunned. I am happy with that. Although, it would have been nice to kill him. But...
True.
You just breaking their armor is just always nice.
Dysfunctionaries, turn 5.
Number 3 is going to blitz. That's 3. We're going to go 4, 5.
And throw into 4. 4 does have dodge. But you knock him down. Only one place for him to go. Are you going to follow up?
I will.
Armor 8. Ooh. Let's see a stun, please.
Roll high.
Just stunned. But there's one of my guys in your end zone that is, or on your side, that is now stunned.
Number 7's going to try to pick up the ball before I risk anything else, so... The 1.
3 plus.
Come on!
Got it.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Did I start counting on 2 or 1?
You're good. That's 7.
Okay, so he's got 1 more. And we'll go... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
2's gonna throw a 2-dice block into number 11.
You got him. Lucky for you, because I have block.
Yeah, you only got the 1 spot to go.
You gonna follow up?
I will.
Armor 9? No.
Close.
Number 6 is gonna go... Boop. Boop.
Like how you guys say boop every time they go.
That's what lizard. Number 1 throw a 1-dice block straight ahead.
I do not have dodge. Wish I did. Seems it comes up more often than the block one.
Do I need to follow up?
No?
I'm okay where I'm at.
Armor 9?
10!
No.
Skink's gonna go for the 1-dice block.
He's the hero need, not the one he deserve. No! Well, that worked. You want to use your reroll?
Nope.
So we both get knocked down. See if you can beat my armor of 8. Again, with the double knockdown actually helping you. This is the second time you've done a double knockdown. And, okay, stunned. Still, that is uncanny. Beat your armor of 7. Yes, and I get plus 1 to the table, come on! 7, so still stunned. So, he's kind of already face down. He's down. Corn Crusher's turn 6. Standing number 9 up, and he'll, that's 3, 4, 5. I'm gonna stand number 7 up. Number 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Number 5 is gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Go for it. Good. 11 is just gonna stand up. Number 1's gonna blitz. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Go for it. Okay, I'm gonna use my last reroll because I cannot leave that open. Thank you. Will be a 3-die blitz or a block because it's strength 4 with horns plus 5 or plus 1 for 5 against 2. No reroll. I'm still worried about it because of that. I'm actually tempted to take. Oh no, I get a second block. I get a second block with a push because I'm frenzied. I'm gonna take the risk and I'm gonna push you. I'd like to knock you down. It'll knock me down too, but it's, you still have 3 more turns, so I'd like to not have a guy knocked down and probably stunned because that seems to be what happens whenever we roll the double block. So I'm gonna push you back straight. Yeah. Yeah. And then I will I have to follow up in frenzying and I have to throw a second block. Only at strength 4 this time. Don't backfire! Okay, it's a push. Oh, yeah. Push.
No, he's not the sidestepper. Oh!
Because you could have done it last time, too.
Yeah.
So I have to follow up. I'm sorry, I should have done a 2 plus go for it for that second block. Okay, we're good. Yep. I'm going to take the risk for a 1-die block against 5 from 8. Okay, it's a push. I will be satisfied with that. I'll push him over here, and I will follow up to engage number 7 even more. End of my turn, these two are no longer stunned. Your skink still is. Ah! He almost did it again! Turn 6! You were this close! I was so ready. I have no rerolls left, so I'd really appreciate a reroll.
Gonna go for a dodge. Whoop!
3+, rerollable. Because he has a dodge skill, so you don't even have to use a reroll. I know, but now you've filled one. Just drop it. Don't think about it so hard.
Okay.
Good. Give yourself some sort of, like, heart problem.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
So if I don't stop you, then I'm in trouble.
Number one is going to throw the blitz, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Ugh, he was my guy that could do it. 2 dice, no special rules. You got him. Man, when are we going to fail one of these? And then actually have it hurt you. Armor 8, no.
Number 2 will throw a block straight ahead.
Dang it. Fail one. This is such a pivotal time, and you just need to fail one. Mm. Armor 8. Not. Oh, yeah, he's hurt. What happens to him, though? Ooh, out of the game. Possibly injured further. Injury table. Yeah, he's permanently injured. That's a serious concussion. He's going to miss the next game, and it's minus 1 armor.
Number 3, I think, next. 1, 2, 3, 4... He was here, right?
Try again.
1, 2.
That's good. Yeah. Sorry. It's the way you're holding it.
Yeah,
it's the way you're holding it. It's making it look like different squares.
Because I'm counting the squares. Okay. So he's here.
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We're gonna go for it.
Oh! You gonna use your last reroll? Or do you want to do a turnover? Are you satisfied with where everybody is?
Not entirely, but. I don't want to use that re-roll up. So, nope. Down he goes.
Armor 9. Oh, he's fine. Wait, are they armor 8?
No,
they're armor 9. Yeah. I don't know why I thought they were 8 for a second. Corn Crusher's turn 7. I got to stop your guy, but first off, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm going to stand up number 2. Number 5 will just move over. And then this is my only chance to stop a touchdown. 9 is declaring a blitz. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Throw a block on a, go for it. Good. 2 dice block, no rerolls. Dang it. So it really just comes down to 1 dodge roll for you. And it's a 3+ rerollable, and then you get a touchdown. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, yeah. And then you're gonna tie it up. You're gonna make us do overtime? That's lame. You throw a dice even block against 4, I'll have help, you'll have help, but I've got block. Okay, got ya. I'll knock it back here. I will not follow up. Armor 9. Nope. Take a big risk here, I'm gonna dodge and do a foul. 2+ dodge for number 8. Good. And then 2, 3, 4, 5, and a foul with help. So I gotta roll 7 or higher. No doubles though. Got it. I skink die. Yeah, that's a 10. It's out for the rest of the game, at least. Injury chart. And he is permanently injured. I think that, would you call that 3 a cocked?
No.
He's 3? Okay. 53 is minus 1 movement and misses a game. And 1 will not activate because I'm not going to throw a bad block. Yeah, you just need a 3+ rerollable dodge. But first, turn 7. Want to do anything else first? Want to throw a block?
I'll stand up.
Oh, and throw a block.
Stand up and go. Mop.
Okay. Blitz. He's blitzing.
3.
He could have advantage with the blitz.
He even spared me, so he blitz. So 3, 4, 5.
Boom. Throw a block. Dang it, I gave him a good idea. That's a push. That means it's a touchdown. I gave you a good idea because that's less. That re-rollable is better than, yeah. Overtime.
Do the lame little I'm full of chicken wings happy dance.
Touchdown, come on, longer than that. Give the audience what they want to see. Work for it. There's a turnover, or there's a kickoff, so number 10 come back on finally, 4+. Come on, 3 in a row. Welcome to the kill the opponent turn, where all we do is try to kill the opponent because there's only 1 turn left and there's no way either of us could get a touchdown unless something really weird happened. Kick off the ball, eh? No, put it. You're supposed to put it like way back there to give me the 1 chance to get it. No, okay, fine. And scatter. 4 to the 2. 1, 2, 3, 4. And kickoff event. This one always freaks me out. Okay, that other 4 doesn't count. 10. Blitz. Oh, frick. You get a free turn with everybody who's not engaged.
Do I?
I'll make a deal. I'll give you a reroll if you just say that we didn't do that.
No.
Out of the ball, one more. Well, this is one of the few ways you possibly could have got a touchdown. Oh, this sucks. This is the worst possible thing that could have happened for me to do.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
You gonna go for it? You happy where you are?
I will go for it.
Where?
This way.
Okay.
Number 2. We go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
And go for it. Fall on your face and die. Oh! Just I wanted it to happen, but armor 9? Okay, he's fine. Oof. Corn Crusher's turn 8. Number 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. Actually, hold on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Number 2. 1, 2. Just can't take any chances here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then blitz with 1, my friend's ear. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Hold on, could you have gotten? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, there we go. 5, 6. Throw a block at strength 6. 2 dice, but no rerolls. Gotcha. So no touchdown for you. Good, sir. Armor 9. Oh. Number 11 with block. We'll throw block into 1. Got him. And I'm just going to leave him lying there because what do you... Actually, no. I want to make you do stuff. Armor 9. Oh. 8 will throw a block into 6. Yeah, I've already used my blitz. Got him. And we'll knock him back here. And I will not follow through. Or... No, I will not follow through. Armor 9. There we go. Come on, give me something more permanent than stunned. Oh, knocked out. 50-50 chance he's not coming into overtime. Number 6 is going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I know it gives you a chance to knock him down, but it also gives me the advantage against number... Actually, against either of them. So let's throw it against 4. No, I don't have the advantage against him. No. So we'll throw it against 5, where I'll have the advantage. Push. Well, that's the best I'm going to do with him, and I'm not going to follow through because, or follow up, because I don't want to give you any more blocks than you deserve. Then turn 8 for the dysfunctionaries.
Do number 4 one dice block into number 6.
So I've got help, so we're both strength 4. Push.
Follow up. Number 5.
Oh, you wanted to get yourself an extra block. I guess the only way you got the extra block is if you didn't hurt me.
Right.
So, 2 chances to really hurt. Oh! Want to use your reroll? You might as well.
Yeah, I'll use the reroll now.
Yeah, at this point, that would just be end of game and a possible injury for you. Okay, there's a push.
He'll stand up. We'll throw a blitz here, so we'll go...
1, 2, 3, 4. You've got advantage. Got him. Yeah, that's like a dodge, or frenzy, not dodge. So, does it really matter where you push him?
I don't know, we'll say that we push him here.
And where do you want him to go?
Straight back there, yeah.
Okay. Following up. Gonna follow up anyways. And armor 8. Oh, this is my frenzying guy. Please just stun him. Please just stun him.
You beat him?
Stun him!
Cigar!
Yes! Oh. Yes! He didn't beat him up. Number 10 did. And he's been on the bench for like the most of the game, all right?
True.
And that is the end of the second half. We are going into overtime. Ugh. Please come back, number 10. Yay! Please don't come back, Saurus Warrior. Yay! Overtime!
This game brought to you in part by Deadpool, made only from the deadest of the bulls.
Meh, I take offense to that. You are at a significant disadvantage numbers-wise. Oh, you're going there?
Yep.
You're going there?
Yep.
Oh, I hope we roll that I get a free turn before you go. Because I'm going to murder that skink so bad. Because without a skink, you basically have very, very little chance of scoring.
True.
But, yeah, so I've got lots of guys. I've got nine guys to your six. But more importantly, you've got your heavy hitters, all except one. Two, actually. You lost your Croxagore. But you've lost 3 out of 4 of the Skink, which I think I'd rather take out the Skinks than the Saurus, just because they're the scorers. And this one's, is he anything special, number 7?
Nope.
He is the naked one. Doesn't have the leap or the sidestep. Or the other one had something, didn't
you
he?
You killed the one with leap.
I killed the one. Oh, I killed the one with leap.
Yeah.
Sweet. All right.
And then the one with sidestep, that was minus one move and is missing the next game.
He's missing it. He has sidestep with minus one move. Gotta love that. I got my Frenzier here, my plus one agility guy here, my blocker here, and my dodger here. And obviously you've deployed your guys like that, so I'm obviously going to have to try to drop the ball over here and hope that it scatters this way. One to the one. I'm good with that because it just means you don't get it unless we roll a good kickoff event. Don't roll a 5. A 10 would be nice. 4. Perfect defense. The kicking team's coach may reorganize his players and a legal defensive formation! 1 and 6 will advance a little. 8 will as well. I'm going to move 5 and 2 over. Yeah, like that. And I'm going to move my dodger this way as well. Yeah. There we go. Let's scatter it one more time. Well, at least it's towards you. Dysfunctionary, turn 1 in overtime. And remember, this is sudden death overtime. This is not the traditional Blood Bowl. As soon as one team scores a touchdown, the game is over. No draws allowed, so we have to play this to the very bitter end. Or, I guess the other option is to kill the opponent's team down till they have only 2 players that can set up, and then have a turnover, or if the half ends and you only have 2 guys,
then yeah,
then you have to automatically give up.
Let's start with 7. Gotta go.
Just a move.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Drop the ball, drop the ball. 3+! Oh, you got it. I'd be asking for too much for you to drop it right there, right
immediately,
now.
Immediately, yeah.
So 6.
7.
And back.
8.
Any go for it?
Yep.
2+. Oh, you want to use a reroll?
Here comes a reroll.
Okay, don't roll a 1 again. You're good. Would you like to go for it again?
No!
Oh, that makes me happy.
1 is going to go 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3.
Defend the skink.
1, 2, 3. Number 5 and number 11. I'm just going to go for it at this point.
Yeah, I got the block skill.
Ow! Don't kill my guy with the block skill! I need him! I need him!
You're going to follow up? No. Armor 9!
Roll me a 10!
No.
It'll end up being a 2-dice block. I'm going to call it the Blitz, though.
Might as well. Want some extra movement. Got him. Knock my guys down, will ya?
So we'll go.
Only give me Blitz, will ya?
Here?
You've used one of your movement for the block anyways.
Yep.
Follow up the spree.
I don't think I really need... No, I'm not going to follow up.
Number 9. Dang it.
Woo!
Dang it. Dang it. Okay, stunned. Ugh. Ugh. You're being too efficient with your guys.
And then he'll go...
2, 3. Yeah, protect the ball. Corn Crushers, turn 1. All 11 will stand up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Essentially what I have to do is just surround you. I know I'm going to be giving you lots of opportunities to block. Maybe you'll even up the number of players on each side.
Yeah.
Which I really hope won't be the case, but I got to try it. So he's going to move there. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2. I'm tempted to put him right here. No, right to there. I'm going to keep 4 back in preparation for your skink finding his dirty little way through. 10 will go up. And then my Frenzier will block, or blitz, sorry. 1, 2, 3, 4. Throw a block. Strength 5 with help. So. Gotcha. Boom. I've got to follow up. Come on, die. Nope. My stun guy is no longer stunned. Oops, sorry, buddy. Dysfunctionary's turn 2.
Actually, I could call the Blitz there.
That's what you want to do. So you changing your mind?
You're gonna go 2 into 2.
2v2. It's like, never mind. Oh, it is the push. I am happy with everything that fails to knock me down.
Go number 3 into number 5.
No help. But doesn't matter. You got the best one. Down he goes.
Let's go here.
Follow up or no?
I want to, but let me see where he can get through.
He's gonna push him back that way and follow up.
And follow up.
Armor 8. Dang. Just stun him, please. Just stun him. Just stun him. Yay. And face down. Oh, sorry, buddy. You're still up.
He's gonna call blitz.
Who's he gonna throw it against?
Number 1.
So it'll be dice. You got the advantage because you got help, so you're strength 5, and I got help, so I'm strength 4.
Yeah.
Oh! Reroll? Okay, let's see double skulls again. I'll even take the other skull one. Nah, you got him. Well, I have to be happy with the forced reroll at least. Following up. Armor 8. Good. Now the skink goes?
Yep. So he's gonna go 1, 2.
And then dodge.
3 for the dodge.
Yep, reroll. Oh no! Oh no! Oh! That reroll, man.
I know.
So that's 3 so far.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Number 1 into number 6.
Yep. Yeah, he's not the dodger. Armor 8. Dang. Oh, dang. Just stun, please. Good. Still lots of guys stunned.
Number 4 into number 8 now.
Got help. You got him. Oh, I need more dodgers. Armor 9, at least you won't hurt him, right?
10!
No. Gorg Crusher's turn 2. So I know exactly who's gonna be blitzing, so everybody else who can stand up will stand up. Number 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then it all comes down to this. Number 4 will blitz. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Block. I got a reroll. Gotcha. That's what I needed. Knock you down. I will follow up, and then we'll see if I hurt you first. Armor 7. Oh, now I've tempted to foul him. And scatter the ball. 3. It's a bit risky. Or, no, I already threw a blitz. I was gonna say he could throw a blitz and go pick up the ball, but no. He's just going to go and pick it up. I gotta dodge and pick it up. Dodge! 3+. Good. Save that reroll for when I go to pick it up. 2, 3, 4. 3+!
Uh-huh.
I'll use my first reroll. Thank you. There we are. I get to move one more space. It's my last movement to move up to here. Number 10 will throw a block into 5 with help from 2, so it's strength 6. There we are. I will knock him down this way, and I will follow up for sure. Armor 9. No. End of my turn, stun guy is no longer stunned. This functionary is turn 3. Your 5 will stand up.
Number 1 will blitz. We'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 2.
Throw a block. 2 dice. You got him. Yeah, he's not the one with dodge. Really wish he was. He beat his armor 8. Oh, it was a 1. The other died. Cheated. So, armor injury check. Just stunned. Well, at least you're only stunning me. I gotta at least hand that to the dice. And move one more splitter. You could go for it, or you could just be happy with where you are.
And go for it up to here.
2+. You're good.
Number 2 will go 1, 2, 3, 4. Skink will stand up. That's 3. And then try for 4.
Skinks have stunty, so they never get a negative modifier to their 3+ dodge.
Go for number 3 into number 5.
You got advantage. 5's not a dodger.
So we'll go ahead and...
This is tense. So close. Armor 8. Good.
Number 4, 1 die block into number 8.
Push. Where would you like to push him?
I'll push him back that way.
and follow up. Corn Crushers, turn three. Number five's gonna stand up. Number six's gonna stand up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. My Roger Dodger is going to advance. 1, 2, 3. Nine's gonna throw a block against five. Strength 6. Gotcha. Down he goes. And I am not going to follow up. You're good. 10's going to move. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yep, I'm happy with that. 1 is my friend's ear, but I'm not going to blitz with him. I'm going to go 1, 2, 3, 4. Just to there. And now I will declare a blitz on 11 and throw a block against 2 with help, so I will have the advantage. Fuckers, though. Gotcha!
Oh.
Oh, wow. All that deliberation. I'm going to knock him back to here. Yes. And I will, obviously, follow up. 1. Armor 9. Oh, we're at least stunning them. Yeah, stunned. On your face, soldier! 2, 3, 4, 5. What the heck? I'm going to go for it. If I go for it twice, then I can actually just run to the end to the end zone with 2 go for it. 2+. Good. Go for it. 2+. Good. Didn't even have to use a reroll. 8's going to throw a block against 4. I'll use one of my 2 rerolls. Oh, come on.
Come on.
No! Oh! Dang it. Why did I take that chance? That was dumb. Man, if I just didn't throw that, I would have just tied you up. Why did I do that? I was rolling so many good dice. I'm like, oh yeah, the dice are on my side. They haven't made us have bad blocks all game. Oh, I take that back.
Start here, stand up. And go. 2, 3, 4.
Oh, that's, now you're doing go for it. Took you 3 to stand up.
Oh, yeah.
So that's 6 right there.
Never mind then, I'm just gonna put him back on him. See if I do some damage, number 3 and number 9.
You've got help. Nope, push. Is your last reroll?
Push. Nope. Try number 1 into number 5.
It's a push. Ooh, hey, my guys aren't dying.
Push, yeah, and I will follow this one up.
What are you doing?
Oh, I'm throwing a blitz.
Okay.
Sorry, yeah.
You just started moving, and I knew what you wanted to do, but
2,
that's it. To 2.
3, 4, 5, 6.
Go for it.
Go for it.
You still have a reroll, so the go for it aren't scary.
Yes,
but you really don't want them to use up your reroll. Oh no, because I've got block. 2+. Okay.
And then I get now to go for it to throw a hit.
No reroll this time. 2+. Never has a 2+ look so terrifying. You got it. Single die block, and I've got block. Oh no!
That's what worse could happen.
It's not a loss yet.
Ah!
Down you go. Armor 9. No. Corn Crushers, turn 4. Just in case. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Number 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6, 1, 2, 3, 4. I know I'm going to drop the ball, so I'm just getting ready for it. 4, 5. And now we go for the touchdown. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Go for it! 2+. Okay. And another go for it. I have 1 reroll left. So it's a 2+ rerollable, which we've all seen fail.
Do it.
2+. Oh, the touchdown! The Corn Crusher victory!
Touchdown!
Let's do our post-game stuff. First off, each side gets to choose an MVP. 1, 2, 11. 2. So number 2. That actually levels them up. Sweet. And you gotta include your dead guys. 6. Not your dead guy. Number 6. Does that level them up?
It takes that does.
From 2 to 7. Nice. Next up, we have improvement rolls. I have 3 guys that leveled up, and the Lizardman side has 2. So I'm going to roll them all, and then off camera we're going to figure it out, because sometimes it could take a while to choose one. Number 2, I roll a double, and I get an 8, so I could choose a double skill. Sweet. Number 4, 9, that's just a new skill. I think I know what I'm going to be giving him block. He's already got dodge, so block is most likely what I'll give him. 10, is 11, which is increasing agility or a new skill. I'd have two Chaos Warriors with plus one agility. That plus one agility is, I don't know if it ever mattered. I don't know if I ever rolled a two, but it sure made me more confident.
It's nice to have the option.
So I'll think about it. The near side, your number two, just getting a new skill, and number six, also a new skill. What we've decided on, I've decided to take dodge on number two, block on number four, which means he now has dodge and block, which is kind of scary. And number 10 was the hardest, because taking that extra agility would be super nice, but it's not, if it was a beastman, I don't even know. Having the extra agility on number eight has made me much more confident to dodge and everything, but I don't think that actually came up that I didn't roll, I don't think I ever rolled a two for his. Not that that means it's not good, I just don't think I need two Chaos Warriors with plus one agility. And so I'm going to give 10 guard. And what guard does, it allows him to assist other people's blocks, or when they're being blocked, even if he has other enemies in his tackle zone. Lee had one of his guys with this, and it was pretty awesome, so I really want that.
Much the same over here. I'm going to go for guard.
Number two.
And then number six is going to go for block.
So good combo. Next up, we're going to generate our winnings. Now, I get plus 10,000 for winning, and I get to reroll the d6. And you get plus 10,000 for having one fame,
yep.
But you do not get to reroll the d6. So go ahead, generate your winnings. So 20,000. 20,000, I'm going to reroll that. Oh, 30,000. Now we see if we gain more fans. I have four fan factor, and I won, so I get to roll 3d6. I have to beat four. So I got it, so now I'm up to five. You have three fan factor, and you roll two dice. Don't roll double one, and we both go up a fan factor. In the end, I have 160,000 gold to spend, and I'm like, hey, it's the semifinals. If I don't spend it now, I'm just going to go, it's just going to go to waste. So I'm going to spend 150,000 of it on a Minotaur. And now we just have to scramble and get the model ready.
Yep.
But we've got another week and a half before we're going to be playing our second game. Not for you guys, of course. It's already there by the time you're watching this, but we've got some time to pass. Now, you don't have any money to spend.
I only have about 40,000, so it's not enough for me to really buy anything, so...
One of your skinks is dead. Now, this skink is out for a game, so you have to hire in two journeyman skinks.
Correct.
Which do add to the value, but you lose a bit of value because those two skinks that are out both had upgrades.
Right.
So your final value is 1.18 million?
Yes.
And my final value with the Minotaur is 1.32 million. It bloats me a lot, but it didn't bloat me as much as 150K because I have a beastman who's sitting out for a game. And normally I have to bring, I'd have to bring in a journeyman beastman, but now I don't have to because I have 11
so you're
players.
Adding, yeah, but you, so you won't have the reserve.
So I won't have a reserve, not until game three, if there is a game three. But that would assume that if you want, that, but either way, it works for me because if there's a game three, that means, well, I'm still playing, obviously. So we're good.
So
this is not a game three.
It all comes out in the wash.
Either way, if I win the second game, he'll be ready for the finals. And if I lose the second game, he'll be ready for the final of our three-up match. But you will also get 140K of inducements in the next game. So you have some options of what you can do with that. And you can throw in some of your own money if you really want to as well, which you might get desperate for because if you lose it, you're out anyways, right? So that is game one of three. The other two games, I don't know if there's gonna be two.
It might be, I don't know.
There's, you know, it's a good match. I killed your Croxagore right away. And that really made a big difference.
Getting
so,
out of the game immediately, was huge.
And then I knocked down enough of you guys that you were always playing with too few players, even if it's just one or two less than me. And so next game, if I don't do that, which is quite possible, you're tough. You got lots of tough guys. Now you have a garter and you got a block. And so that's going to make things a lot harder. So you could easily win the next game. Just all comes down to dice rolls and a lot of luck, and of course some tactics as well. So the link in the video description below will be to the next games. Go and watch them now. If you're not a Vault member, you can still click them, get a free 7-day trial to the Mini Wargaming Vault, get instant access to all of the other Blood Bowl games that have been, that you've already missed, because obviously if you're not a Vault member, you've missed half of them. You can go back and binge watch those. Everything gets accessed for free for the first 7 days. Happy Wargaming.